هذه شريعة الله. How successful were the religious thinkers in spreading Islam in subcontinent during the 18th and 19th centuries? Biography and beliefs. Haji Shariatullah was born in 1781 in Faridpur, Bengal. His father was an ordinary farmer. At the age of 18, he went for Hajj in 1799. He stayed in Saudi Arabia from 1799 to 1818 and received his religious education there. Then he returned to Bengal. Muslims living in poor condition in Bengal were greatly influenced and motivated by his leadership. During his stay in Arabia, he was greatly influenced by Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, who had initiated the Wahhabi movement in Arabia. Beliefs. He believed that Muslim community had moved away from Islamic practice and were taking influence from other religions such as Hinduism. He wanted the Muslim community to return to the farz, the proper observation of Islamic practice. He realized that the miserable condition of Muslims have led the country being Darul Harab, the area where non-Muslims rule. He supported the idea of jihad against the non-Muslims who were undermining the true principles of Islam. Farizi movement. Muslims were living in poor conditions and they were given fewer opportunities for jobs. He wanted to restore their pride. He started a movement in the 19th century named as Farizi Movement for Muslims in Bengal. The movement was targeted to restore the pride of the Muslim and removed what he thought were the Hindu practices. Haji Shariatullah I from his fathers to adopt Tawbah for past sins and pledge to lead a righteous, that is, in accordance with Islam and its teaching. The Farizi Movement provided a platform to Muslims to work together and fight the bad treatments of Hindu zimindars. Haji Shariatullah regarded British domination in Bengal as detrimental to the religious life of Muslims. The Hindus were troubled by the unity of the Muslims peasants and opposed Haji Sahab. The Hindus put false allegations against him and forced him to leave Dhaka. Haji Sahab returned to Faridpur and continued his fight. He categorized East Bengal into areas called Circle with their own Khalifa, who was responsible for their wealth. He died in 1840. After his death, his son Mohsinuddin carried his legacy. Please don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram and LinkedIn, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.